Oh.
Somebody always sent it.
Harwood's guess.
Come around with it. Yes, they're going. He can lift his, he can lift the leg in his own. But it's not.
Yeah.
When I last I heard.
So most times. They're not really saying, they haven't really given them like.
Everybody wanna do.
Long term, yeah. The only thing they did say was that.
How you doing, Joe?
Started that his muscle tone was really good. So that, you know, there was a really good chance that, you know, a lot of it could come back. And I guess it just depends on how hard he works.
I remember.
You know, now that he's home, they've got him 3 days a week.
You don't like him?
A place over around, Western Hills. Yeah. So, and then they just got him fitted for a brace for his arm and his leg. So that should help some. Everything that they, every test that they ran, it all goes back to.
Because the water over there, I don't have a dog, but people always complain about the water.
And she just kept
up
in his nose and saying, we'll watch it. And he came in a week before that happened. And me and him was talking, and he said, yeah, he said, I've gained weight, and, you know, my blood pressure's back up again. And I said, well, what'd she do for it? And he goes, well, she just upped my dose and said that we would monitor it. And I said, has she got you on any kind of, like, a Lasix or Arpil to counteract some of that? And he's like, no. Yeah, and he goes, no, not at all. And I said, that just don't sound right, Gene. I said, you know, my dad had a triple bypass when he was 36 years old, so I've been around it my whole entire life. And I said, for her to be, you know, just upping your dose, she's got to do something to it. Yeah, to equal that out. And she.
Definitely. Every time I open my drawer, it's not so good. As Smith's or Terry's.
It ain't no hurry. It ain't no hurry. I just. What are you doing, babysitting?
Staying busy?
Both of them. Hey, Tony.
How much are they for a daily?
It's Sunday.
I'm
pressing
on the ceiling. I'm putting the stuff down. Just for like
spider,
yeah.
Oh,
yeah. It's free. We only have to pay the Pacey to get in there.
How much is in there? Let's see if I got too much or not.
Get in between the rain showers.
Five for everybody would be good. Yeah, it all even out then.
Anything that's got a title to it.
My kick drum's got that boom, you know.
Yeah, I was bringing them down last week.
Yeah. Well,
but
I'm gonna need a couple of them
them murals too.
Okay.
These two of them.
Well, we just saw that and I was like, I didn't know. They don't. So now we
just pick it in and take them camping with me.
Right.
Carry them on the water.
I'm just telling you, that's how many we got.
Thanks.
27.
Senior discount.
I got a fax to Brandon.
What about the senior discount?
What's the voice of Indiana?
What?
The voice of Indiana.
That's how I don't know what to do with the school. It's a program to the school. Marshburg High School.
Okay.
We're doing enough for that.
But you know what I mean? You're going to have to get that across to the people at AAP.
Got high school?
Yeah.
So many people for so many kids or something? Because yeah, you need so many people to watch so many kids.
Something to write on. Who knows?
He says right here. But I don't know if he's here. I don't see any of them yet. He's here. She's in. Is Bill Bill here?
He was at work today, so I assume Mario's here. I don't know for sure. Sure. Thanks.
Okay. Question. When you ordered the shirts for the pool, did you just order the lifeguards and that? You didn't order headers.
Do we need two more people?
No, it's okay. I'll take care of it. That's fine. That's fine. No problem. It has pool on it, but it has other stuff. Yeah. I'll take care of him. Don't worry. Because I asked him tonight, that's okay. You and Tony's, right? Okay. 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 That's fine.
Brother. He's told me.
Yeah.
A couple times. Kevin.
Uh-huh. That's fine.
I don't know if he butt dialed me or what. He said he called me. And I missed his call, so I called him right back. And it rang, and never answered. And then the one time, he called me, and I messaged it and went to voicemail, and I picked up voicemail, and it was like he butt dialed me. So I don't know.
I don't know.
If you see him, I don't know. And that's true.
Yeah, I guess.
Well, that was
I think we got
Saturday
that.
Around 7, 6 or 7.
Kind of looked through it.
I don't know.
I called him back because we were down in the town for my son's. We had a baseball tournament down there all weekend. And I called him back and it rang. And it went to voicemail and I thought, well, he must have
bumped out.
So if you see him, I ask him if he needs something. Yeah.
Now this one we gotta have, this really fly. Yep. That's in the last all the time.
It looks a lot better.
I said,
he says mine.
Well, you know, again, the last one was down at the pool. I was everybody something. That's one of the that lady that's been requested before.
I think guys are
that's one of the ones we had more money.
What did I just say? I said, if it comes up, now you have to talk to somebody else. I said, I haven't heard a thing about it. Well, I told him, I said, that'd be between you and Mara. You guys have to tell them what's going on, but I don't have a clue.
Yeah.
I don't know if yours will come up. Bill.
So, 2 days later, I go to labor, and the sheriff shows up. Yeah, this is the. And I told him, I said, I don't care. As long as it's center line.
Right.
Member Aaron Cook.
Here.
Member Bill Bruner.
Here.
Member Mario Todd. Not here. President Mayor Dennis Carr. He's here. Assistant Police Chief Mike Lanning.
Present.
Deputy Fire Chief Rob Schutte.
Present.
Oh, Bobby's out of town. Attorney Leslie Votaw. She's here.
I'm here.
Utility Director Owen Clausen. Owen's not here. And myself.
Any announcements? Hearing none approved minutes, previous meeting.
And so moved.
And that will include the executive session memorandum.
Yeah. Second.
We'll have to wait till the next time. Neither one are here. Neither one of these gentlemen were there.
So. Next meeting.
You do that.
Okay.
Okay. Committee reports. Fire department.
Nothing to report, Mayor.
Police department.
Nothing to report, Mayor.
EMS not here, okay.
He's in Canada.
Building inspector, Paul?
Well, I was looking to see what you had me under.
Yeah, what board was?
Is it under this one right here? Yes, Your Honor, we had a couple of buildings we'd like to discuss this evening on the agenda. I'm going to do this first one here real quick. We have a lady that came down from the bank. It's 440 Walnut Street. What I'd like to do is request from the board a little more time on this one here. They've done their due diligence on the outside and inside, cleaning up. And they would like a chance to go ahead and look at the building and take a look and see about the structural parts and see whether they wanted to advance or not, why it's with them. And I feel like that's the way they reacted to cleaning it up. I think that's a fair statement to give them some time to take a look at what they actually have. And she's here if she'd like to speak.
Represent the lender. You need to come to the podium, please.
Yes, we can, so we can you, pick please. You up.
Just a question, Carl. This was the one that we actually went and cleaned up.
I've told her about
porch in the yard.
Yeah.
Okay.
Could you state your name, please?
Absolutely. It's Rebecca Algenio, Algenio. It's my understanding the city's already incurred about a little over $200 in cleaning up the front of the property, and my client understands that that will take priority over its mortgage. It came in this weekend and did a full cleanup of the exterior of the property. I think there were about four trailers on site. And so they understand that there are structural issues, and they have ordered structural bids, so they want to figure out what the cost of the structural repairs are versus the cost of demolition. The building inspector shared with me it's probably about $18,000 to demolish it. So once we figured out what the cost of demolition is versus the cost of repairs, they can make that decision as to whether or not they want to spend the money to make the repairs or instead incur the cost of demolition. And we'd be happy to tender the proposal of what they'd like to do to the building inspector once that's done.
I feel good with that right there. That's a step farther than we have been in 2 years.
So. Anything on the board?
Yeah, I live close to the area, and I've seen four or five trailers of trash come out there this weekend, and it's looking pretty good, so I agree with Carl on the issue.
Okay.
I don't have a problem with it either. Carl, we can, we really haven't started anything formally anyway.
No, this was just she came, and there's no need to start anything formally until I hear back from her.
Thank you
very much. I don't, unfortunately, but I'd be happy to give you my phone number. My direct number is 513-322-7893, and my email is Rebecca, Rebecca, period, Algenio, at rslegal, legal.com. We're the law firm that's handling the foreclosure action.
Okay. Great. Thank you for the information.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay. A new business in D. Abbott, pool admission prices.
Mayor, I've got one more.
Okay, go ahead.
The other building I'd like to discuss tonight is 215 Margaret. We've had people contact us over probably the last year or so for electricity and different things like that. I believe you got in your packet there pictures. This building here, I would like to go ahead and start and ask and request an unsafe building hearing on it so we can do the due diligence and bring the owner in.
Anything aboard?
I guess, Carl, can you tell us a little? I mean, we can see the pictures, but what?
Well, we have structural damage, and I'm sure that the house, when I say sure, I'm never going to say that again. I would assume that this house is full of mold. It's full of rodents. Those pictures are taken pretty clear through the windows. I could have walked in, but I've learned not to do that, too. And the roof's fallen out of it. Ceilings are out of it, the floors are out of it, the buildings have been added onto and they're separating. This is going to be, and we can discuss it once at the hearing if we have an owner show up, what the city would like to see done to it. We're never against the repairs. If they want to take it down, like I said, when we get into the unsafe building hearing, I'll give you a list of what I think should be done.
What kind of contacts have been made with the owner?
More than once.
Okay. And you've been able to talk to him or not?
I informed him on the phone the last time that this building was coming up and I was requesting an unsafe building hearing on it. And anything, and keep in mind, on the unsafe building hearing, no decisions have to be made. He can stand and tell us exactly what he wants to do, and as a board, you can accept or deny it. But just because we have an unsafe building hearing doesn't mean that this building's actually going to be leveled. I mean, he could come in and say that he has this, put a set of plans, and that would be your vote on it to do what they want to do with it. But I think with the hearing, it's in our ordinance. It sets a timeline so it doesn't just sit there and wait and wait and wait. We have a timeline that we can hear things.
So the formal notice has not been sent to him yet?
Not yet.
Okay. That would be the next step if the board so chooses?
If they vote for a hearing, then I'll go back to Joe, and then we'll do all the due diligence of that part.
Anything else on board?
Make a motion to proceed with unsafe building.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Proceed with what?
Unsafe building proceeding.
Do you have any more, Carl?
That's it, sir. Thank you.
D. Abbott, pool mission prices.
Good evening. I'm here because one of the things we wanted to discuss with the Board of Works this year was the admission pricing on the pool. The last 3 years, the prices have been a daily admission of $8, and these are for non-residents. Residents are still free admission. Individual season passes are $70, and a family season pass for four is $135. We have a senior discount admission of $4, and then a 35 individual pass age 60 and over. The board had decided to raise the price, which used to be $4, to $8 because we had a large overcrowding issue. This was before the city of Greendale had built their new pool, which I can attest that since they have, the overcrowding issue has decreased. The first year we went to $8, there was a lot of grumbling. We still had an overcrowding issue because we were still the best, and I believe at that time, nicest pool to come to in the area, so people still came. Since Greendale has built their new pool, our revenue on admissions has gone down quite a bit. I don't know the exact numbers, but I can tell you from experience of being there, it is less than what it used to be. We don't have the overcrowding issue. Greendale is cheaper than we are on admissions, so we do have an issue with people that come. We are straight $8. There is no cheaper charge for children. They come to the pool, they ask what our admission is. We are $8 a person. Well, we can go to Greendale for $5, or we can go to Rising Sun, which I believe Rising Sun just lowered their price down to $4. So we have been losing a lot of business that way. I know the gaming revenue going down, there's not as much revenue to help generate for the pool. So one of the ideas we have was maybe to lower our pricing down some, to maybe help bring some people coming back to help offset what the burden would be on the taxpayers and the game, you know, having to take from the gaming revenue. We could bring in maybe some more revenue to help compete against with some of the other pools. There's a couple of ideas the board can go whichever way you want to go. If you currently want to keep the prices as the same, that's fine. We can go two different price ranges, $6 for adults, $4 for children. We can go $5 straight across for everybody. We thought maybe adjust the pass pricing to individuals is $70. I can tell you Greendale is $50. They are basically $50 for each person for a pass out there. So we thought maybe lower our individual passes down to $50. Honestly, I think we sold 3 last year of individual passes, and that's it. Because they can go to Greendale and get one for $50, and we're $70. And then maybe make the family passes from $135 to $150, because Greendale is $50 per person. They don't actually have a family price. And then I know we're not actually competing, but to be reasonable, we would still be a little bit less on the family passes and still generate a little bit more to help offset the difference between the individuals. I think the senior discount admission is pretty fair, and their price range of 35 seems to be pretty fair for them. It's not in our policy, but it's not written down, but in the past, and this has been from the time me and Tony have been there, children under two years old have always been free. We'd like to know if the board would still like to continue that policy, even with lowering the prices. I'll tell you honestly, it's been kind of tough over the last couple years, especially to charge a three-year-old $8 to get in. So, you know, it would help ease the burden on our also neighbors, that it would be a little bit cheaper for them to come to the pool, and then maybe raise our concession sales up some too. With the $8 increase, our concession sales have gone down.
Well, I'd like to see everybody seems to got a break on here except the seniors. You know, our seniors, they're locked in at a...
The seniors are discounted. A senior pass is $35.
The daily?
Their daily admission is $4.
And what was that before?
The daily admission before for everybody was $8. Actually, you started the senior discount admission.
Okay, you got the seniors in with the individuals up here, the daily.
No, they're actually down on the bottom. It says senior discount. There, $4 daily admission for a senior, okay, and then a $35 for a pass instead of $75 or $70.
I didn't want to leave them out.
No, no, no.
Thank you.
But if we drop it to the $5, is what you're saying, right? That maybe we should drop the seniors too? Is that what you're saying?
Yep, I'm understanding her. They was paying $8 before?
No, actually, the senior admission has always been $4 from the time. Well, actually, before we went to $8, it was $4 for everybody. That was 3 years ago. 3 years ago, it was changed to $8. Well, we adjusted it to $8. We then made the seniors' admission $4, so they didn't have to pay the $8.
Well, then what I'd like to see is it cut too. Also, to like $2. I mean, our seniors, you know, they don't have a lot of extra money to.
That's entirely up to the board, whatever you guys would like to do.
Any more from board?
I'm good with taking down the passes, the daily business, also the toddlers, the infants. You know, that I've heard a few rumblings about paying for youngsters, you know, young youngsters. So.
Yes.
Yeah.
But I'm good with your proposal. Let's see what happens this summer.
And so that was $5 for the daily admission.
Season pass individual $50.
$50.
Family season pass $150, and under two free.
Seniors $2.
That's what Donnie's proposing.
And that makes it kind of nice for grandparents who bring their grandchildren too. But right. Do you want to leave the individual pass for a senior for $35, or would you like to make that a little different?
No, what the board, $35, something like that.
Are you guys good with that? $25 and $2 for seniors.
$25
for the seniors.
$2 daily. You
want to
put that in your motion?
Let's so move.
Tell us what your motion is going to be.
Well,
we'll make sure we got it.
The daily admission.
$5.
We're talking $5 individual pass, $50 family season pass, $150 seniors daily admission, $2. Individual pass, $25.
And kids under two are free, right?
Kids under two free?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you got that in motion. Have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it.
Thank you.
Thanks, DD.
The only other thing on this one was the pool admission prices. Hollywood has contacted us about possibly... It's in very preliminary conversations, but they cannot offer the guests at the event center any pool. There's no pool there. So they were trying to work something out with us to possibly be able to offer them, you know, admission to our pool. So I just, I don't have much more information than that. Mr. Todd was supposed to elaborate on that, and he's not here. So I would ask that that part of it be tabled. We can talk about it on the 2nd, June 2nd.
Motion table?
I move.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Okay. Pat Crowder, permission for small stage in city park lot, June 13th.
Okay, there are two items there in that first item. I had a committee person working on this event on June the 13th, which is an arts event, and they had requested that. They've since withdrawn that request, so we'll be using the stage over at the Music on the River lot. That will save everybody a lot of trouble, putting up a second stage on that date. So I'd like to move, if possible, to the second item, which is permission for street closure. Our first party in the street is on Friday, June the 5th, and party in the street is a very different event. It has a different time. It's just a very different feeling event than our Music on the River, so we'd like to locate it in a different spot. And we've kind of looked up and down the street and trying not to cause any issues with the event center, etc. And we've identified a location on Walnut Street, but north of center in this next block here. And we've also identified with this, our sound provider, that we could take a stage and angle it so that part of the stage is on the sidewalk, part in one of the, a couple of the parking spaces. That way the city workers do not have to disassemble the stage until Monday, so it wouldn't require any overtime or anything. So, and we will be meeting tomorrow with Hollywood as far as the logistics to make sure that they have a comfort level with this. But in the meantime, we would want to know the city's feeling on this.
Hollywood doesn't have an event that night?
Not to my knowledge.
Now, what's your board?
That was my main concern, is the event, getting to the event center if there's an event.
Well, I think we have kind of, to me, two options. One is we could angle the stage towards center, which means that center would then be closed. The other option is to angle it so that it's facing out towards 50, and then people could still come around via Center Street.
No, he was just concerned Hollywood didn't have an event going on the same night.
Oh, okay. Yeah, to my knowledge, they don't on that Friday. Most of their events are on Saturdays, except in July they do have some Friday events.
Any more from board? Entertain a motion.
So moved.
Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? How's that?
Thank you.
Thank you. Carl Fine, we already addressed you, Carl.
Yeah.
Old business, Mike Clark, 2015 asphalt crack seal quote. Open.
Thank you, Your Honor. Jackie, I believe you have some bids. If you'd like to just open them and read the, it's a price per ton in place. So there's,
yeah, please.
It's a price per ton in place is what they're called for. So
okay, we got two quotes, Paul Rowe and O'Mara.
Yes.
Dave O'Mara is $7,500 per ton in place. Is that what you said?
Correct. Yeah.
Okay.
Is there a minimum to that?
Not to exceed $60,000. I'll get the rest of it here in a minute. Is there anything else on this one I need?
No, that's all we need for now.
Well, that's one. The other one is Paul Rowe. Paul Rowe is $7,500 per ton in place, not to exceed $60,000. Mm-hmm. So they bid exactly the same thing.
Leslie, what do we do?
Flip coin.
Well, I think the board can choose one of them, can't they? We have the option.
Ask Leslie, not me.
The most responsible, I guess, then we need to look whether or not they have all their forms in there now.
Here you go, Mike.
Here you go, Mike. Just double check and see if they have all their forms now. Because if one of them doesn't have everything they need, then that would.
Okay.
That hasn't happened. I don't think I've ever read that.
That's ever happened.
At least with that's about.
Don't we usually do that after we award?
Paul Rowe has all the required forms.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Paul Rowe Company has all the required forms. And Dave O'Mara has all the required forms.
Make it a little easier, will you? What's the board want to do?
I'll make a motion. We go with Rowe.
Paul Rowe.
I'm gonna shot it at once.
You have a second?
Yeah, wait, can we split it? Is there any way to split it up evenly, Mike?
Not evenly. I mean, I can split areas up, but, you know, every street, every crack is a different size, so.
I think you can. I mean, when they came in, you can choose to do however you want if they're tied.
I mean, we I'll do it however you guys want me to do it. We can.
Well, Donnie's got a motion floor.
Yeah, there's a motion on the floor.
You hear a second?
What was the motion?
To go with Rowe.
Go with Rowe.
All right.
O'Mara's done. They did uphill up on Ludlow Hill
and part of the downtown.
Part of downtown, right?
Yes.
Yeah. I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
All again?
Aye.
Okay. Roll call, please.
Oh, okay. Mario, honey, you're supposed to be up front.
Yes, I am.
Okay. Aaron.
No.
Okay. Bill.
Yes.
Donnie?
Yes.
Hey, Mario.
Mario, you got a vote?
I'm going to abstain since I don't have the discussion.
Well, you'd be indulgent a little bit here.
Talk to me.
It's a tie.
Both quotes were exactly the same, Mario.
The motion already went through. I mean, unless you want to rescind the motion.
Get two yeses.
Donnie made a motion to go with Rowe.
It could be.
I don't know how he decided it, but.
I mean, it's already passed at this
point. It's already passed. Yeah. He wasn't here.
It's 2-1.
2-1.
But if the board would like to rescind it and talk about it since Mario walked in, that's up to you, Donnie.
I'm good with it. I made the motion.
Everybody else fine with it?
Well, I know Donnie had some reservations about the first phase of it. I don't know, did you check their work this last phase, Donnie?
Well, they never did finish up on the hill to my satisfaction, but ours may be different, you know.
They did mess that back street there, didn't they?
Yeah, they did.
Hardwood Ridge.
Well, keep in mind, you're paying for the tonnage, so if they didn't do it, you didn't pay for it, but that's still needs to be done.
Yeah, this time we'd start there. Okay.
We have whoever does it. It was rewarded to Rowe.
Okay, and since you did award it, do I have authorization from this board to go ahead and make contact and get this contract executed so we can get it started?
Need a motion.
I'd so move to let him.
Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
All right, thank you.
Okay. Review and discuss claims board approval. Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Motion adjourned?
Wait a minute. Mario, since you were here, can we go ahead and approve the minutes of the previous meeting? Neither one of them were here.
All right, so move.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Yeah, keep us from having to do it next time.
Okay.
Thank you.
I need a motion adjourned?
So move.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Utility board, 5 minutes.
Like your item.
Yeah. Everybody signed it? Are we done? Everybody's good?
Huh? Okay.
I was looking to see if they had any.
Sounds like we're on a minute.
Hey, Mario, can you just say Tom?
Do they have a website?
Yeah. This is Lawrence.
Oh, boy. You know what I'm doing, Tom?
I did, I didn't see it.
I'll go with you.
Get out of it.
I shouldn't have that filled, but I'm.
That's a definitely, please. That's the Board of Works one.
Yeah, the house they're talking about, that 440. They have like, they have a trail over there. 10 feet, oh, yeah, because, you know, Well, the tops, well, there's 42 tires, so, and they're all more water, so they're like, But yeah.
Marshburg, that's a certain amount of town.
I haven't looked at it, but I'm getting it. Because what happened was Alfred used to live, you know him, but he died. Had all the yard sales. And they stole everything.
Like a month here, like before we start in.
You know, when they were down, they're like, you know, we don't want any more. Get back to the bank.
Get up level with the.
That lady was in the bank. That's about how they go.
After my mom, I got to tell you, so you're going to love this. I can name the thing.
That's center in there.
Make another one.
We're saying don't hold it, right?
There you go, it's all there, sir.
Finally got it. I couldn't even get it.
These four warheads.
You need us to send you an agenda for each meeting? Not me. I don't know. Sue's one of my girls today.
I'll
what's your email? I can scan.
I don't know. That's not going to be it.
Do you? Okay, that's fine.
Hey, whatever you do, don't go to
the Connie sends them to me. Yeah, okay. That's fine, Connie. Not a problem. Okay.
It's just that.
Without a what?
Without the agenda, I would have been
Oh.
This hit me.
Yeah.
This was a good
Okay.
Yeah, you're right. That's probably
Leslie, is Olin gone or in town? Or?
Back tomorrow.
This piece of mail probably should go to him.
Yes, thank you.
I'll see him tomorrow. You want me to give it to him? I guess two plus conference at like 1:15 at least.
Sure, why not?
Call utility board meeting to order. Roll call, please.
Member Jane Pope?
Here.
Present. Member Aaron Cook.
Here.
Member Bill Brunner.
Here.
Member Mike Lawrence.
Here.
Member J.R. Holcraft.
I'm here.
Attorney Leslie Votel.
Here.
Utility Director Olin Clausen, who is absent. President Mayor Carr.
Here.
And myself.
Any announcements? Hearing none, approved minutes, previous meeting?
Oh, move.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Committee reports, Olin's not here. New business have none, old business have none. Review and discuss claims, board approval.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Motion adjourned.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
That's gonna be a record.
It does.
Roll call, please.
Oh, hang tight a minute. I'll get to it. Something else. Member Jane Pope.
Present.
Member Aaron Cook.
Here.
Member Bill Brunner.
Here.
Member Mike Lawrence.
Here.
Member J.R. Holcraft.
Here.
Assistant Police Chief Mike Lanning.
Here.
Deputy Fire Chief Rob Schutte.
Here.
Bobby Mills is absent. Attorney Leslie Votel.
Here.
Utility Director Olin Clausen, he's absent. Mayor Dennis Carr.
Here.
And myself.
Any announcements?
Yeah. I'd like to wish J.R. Holcraft a happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
To you.
29?
31.
31?
39.
Just a little bit.
You're younger than me. I'm 39.
All right.
Shut up. Don't even go there.
Approved minutes, previous meeting?
I have one more. I have a question or announcement. Is there any, several people ask me, is there any way to, take up the curbside recycling to more than one time a month, because it's not enough for a lot of people?
Well, matter of fact, we were discussing that.
Okay, when do you think that would take place?
We'll discuss what days, you know,
okay.
What's good to do it.
Okay.
We'll get back.
Okay.
Okay, approved minutes, previous meeting?
I'll move.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Committee reports. Streets, Island, Curbs, Aaron Cook.
No report, Mayor.
Finance, J.R. Holcraft.
No report.
Fire Department.
Nothing to report.
Police Department.
No report, Mayor.
Bobby's not here, Building Department. Okay. New business, Tom Tabbitt. Proclamation for Mental Health Month. You notice how I kind of pushed that proclamation over on you?
Yes, I noticed that. I'll see if I can read through it with my voice. So thank you for the opportunity to address council. May is Mental Health Awareness Month, and SAMHSA, the Substance Abuse Mental Health Services Administration, tries to advertise the awareness to the country. This year, their theme is Before Stage 4. Most of us know a little bit maybe about cancer treatment, where they stage it, level one, where it's just starting out, it's mild, and it goes all the way to four, where it's very severe, and in cancer's case, deadly. Same thing can happen with mental illness. So I will read the proclamation that SAMHSA prepared and the mayor has signed. Whereas mental health is essential to everyone's overall health and well-being, and whereas all Americans experience times of difficulty and stress in their lives, and whereas prevention is an effective way to reduce the burden of mental health conditions, and whereas there is a strong body of research that supports specific tools that all Americans can use to better handle challenges and protect their health and well-being, and whereas mental health conditions are real and prevalent in our nation, and whereas with early and effective treatment, those individuals with mental health conditions can recover and lead full and productive lives. And whereas each business, school, government agency, healthcare provider, organization, and citizen shares the burden of mental health problems and has a responsibility to promote mental wellness and support prevention efforts. Therefore, I, Dennis Carr, mayor of Lawrenceburg, Indiana, do hereby proclaim May 2015 as Mental Health Month in Lawrenceburg. As the mayor, I also call upon the citizens, government agencies, public and private institutions, businesses and schools in Lawrenceburg to recommit our community to increasing awareness and understanding of mental health. The steps our citizens can take to protect their mental health and the need for appropriate and accessible services for all people with mental health conditions before they reach stage four. So I think we all know, again, about the prevalence of mental health. Probably one out of five people in any given year have a diagnosable diagnosis of a mental health condition, and that would include a substance abuse issue. Suicide is a big issue. Worldwide, 1 million people commit suicide successfully worldwide. In the United States, it's 38,000 people every year. For every attempt, there's probably seven, or every committed suicide, there's probably seven that attempt suicide and survive. So that's quite a bit of numbers. Out of our veteran population, 22 vets commit suicide every day in the United States. The VA only knows about five of those people. There's 17 that aren't even associated with VAs. Substance abuse is certainly a big topic. In our area that we serve, the five counties of Southeast Indiana, and it's really an issue across the country. There's approximately 21.6 million people in the United States over the age of 12 that are dependent on some kind of substance. That's 8.2% of our overall population. Nearly three quarters of those individuals, 15.3 million, are hooked on prescription drugs. More than 22,000 Americans die from unintentional prescription drug overdoses, and that number is probably higher now than what it was. What I'm reading was from 2012. Each day, 114 Americans die from prescription drug overdose, while almost 7,000 were admitted to emergency rooms for misuse of opioids and other medications. With our adolescent population, teens are a particular high risk for abusing prescription drugs, given the ease that they can get them from family or friends and the cost of drugs that they can get. Every day in America, 2,500 new adolescents use prescription medications illicitly for the first time in their life. 2,500. So the prevalence is there on a mental health perspective, and certainly on a substance abuse perspective. The good news is that treatment does work. 80% of people who do have problems don't seek treatment, though. So the Community Mental Health Center is here. We serve five counties in Southeast Indiana. Our main headquarters is up by the hospital. We have eight sites here in Lawrenceburg alone, 22 in the total five county areas. So treatment is available, and treatment does work. And so the message is, let's do something before we reach stage four. So thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bill Cunningham, Memorial Day Parade.
Thank you, Mayor. I was here at the last meeting to ask for permission to move forward, and I thank you for bearing that. I've worked with your local departments. They've been very helpful. We've worked with the police, the fire department, the streets. The route is scheduled from the courthouse to the townhouses on Walnut and Wexeter. We're not going to go on 50. There's enough problems on 50 without us getting involved. The fire department's been very cooperative, along with the police department, and on behalf of David McGallers to Post 239 American Legion, I thank them for their help. I thank you for allowing us to do this. We will form at 9:30 at the courthouse. Parade starts at 10, and then the program at the cemetery is at 11, and I think local attorney Mr. Eubank is the speaker. And I'd like to invite all council people that would like to participate, and you can check with the assistant chief surely if they're going to have the sea graves there, and you can ride on that, or you can have your own transportation. But I will also tell you that we're going to invite every candidate in the fall election. They won't be on that particular vehicle. They'll have to furnish their own. But we thought we should do that just to show we're very independent, and the Legion is a nonpartisan group, so we'll work it out best we can. This is the first year in the last two. We didn't have one last year, and we heard a lot of slack from people that we needed to have that to represent the veterans, and it looks like it's going to go well. Like I told Mr. Lawrence, he has a business. He could bring his business vehicle. Anything you all want to travel in is fine. Same offers are going to be made to others. We hope to have a good turnout. I'd say if we don't have the public here this year, it probably won't happen again. We've contacted the radio station, the newspaper. We'll see how it goes. It's good to honor the vets. It seems like it's tougher and tougher anymore to get that recognition. I think we have maybe 15 World War II veterans left in our post. One just turned 90 years old. He's from Alabama. I think half of Alabama was up here for his birthday party. But it was interesting. But I really thank the city for allowing us to do this, and I thank the groups for the cooperation. Are we finalized now? I have to meet with those two gentlemen a couple more times. They're hard to deal with. You got some good people there. So, but we're gonna have it on Memorial Day from 10, and I don't think it'll last over half an hour. And then we go on to the cemetery. Like I said, we won't be on US 50. And look forward to doing it. And another thing, like you all got into, I mentioned I'd take care of it. And so I ended up with the job. So it's up to you to take care of things too for a little while. So, but feel free to participate in the parade. We'd like to have you all there. I've talked to the mayor about it earlier. And even if you're not running again, it'd be good to have you there. I'll see if JR will ride that six-passenger bicycle with Donnie Bryant. I haven't seen the thing yet, but they say it's going to be in there. So we'll have a good time. And thanks again for allowing us to do this. And if you have any questions, feel free to contact me. But everything's been worked out well with your departments, and I think everything's fine. Thank you.
Thank you, Bill.
Thank you.
Dave Roussel, race sponsorship.
Good evening. You should have gotten your packet a proposal for a event package that benefits the residents of Lawrenceburg, and actually residents of 47025, which include Greendale, part of Hidden Valley and stuff. It's the same as last year, as we've done in the past 2 years. The only difference, and kind of a big difference, is on, in the past we had our last event, which is the City of Lawrenceburg Fall Nationals, and what we did in the past was offer a discount for that night. We didn't have a really good turnout because it wasn't pretty, I believe, but for that event. So what we decided to do is, instead of having two events at free admission and one at a discount, we decided to do three events at free admission. So the added date would be the September 5th. Anybody have any questions on that? We only had like a for the Fall Nationals, where it was a discount. I think it was simply $25 admission. Church City residents, is it 12 for that event? And like I said, we only had about 100 take advantage of that. For the other events, the free events was a lot more. I don't have the numbers on that, but it was a really good turnout, and the residents really appreciate it.
You're still able to get the concessions and all that, right? It's still free, right?
Yes.
That's a great thing.
Anything more?
Thank you.
Is this looking at being done of a withhold from the lease like it last year? That would
say we don't have the money, I don't think. And
I know last year was an issue too, and we just credited our lease.
You know what the lease is per year?
Per year, it's upwards of $70,000.
So these are the same two events, except you're adding another event, is that correct?
Yeah, it's the same two. We had three events last year, like I said, two of them were free, one of them was discounted for residents. This year, we're going to have...
Like a one-pager on that, I believe, right, just to amend it?
Yes.
I'm not sure whether or not we include, did we include more than 1 year, or was just for last year?
I believe it's just 1 year.
I don't have a problem, we can prepare something like that again, it's not a problem with what the board wants to do.
I don't have a problem doing it, the lease, obviously, because we don't have any money in any kind of our donation funds or marketing funds.
Well, I'd like to thank you for the three events that you are giving to the citizens of Lawrenceburg for free, and I make a motion that you're asking for $22,000.
Yes.
That be deducted from your lease that you pay on a yearly basis.
Yes.
No second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Judy, and I'll get with you on that.
Okay. Thanks. Jackie Stutt, Devon County Foundation Grants.
Oh. Okay. We have phase one. The first one is the Character Council of Greater Cincinnati and Northern Kentucky. And it's 2 half-day sessions of creating a culture of integrity seminar. They're asking for $4,950, and the foundation recommends $4,950 to support these two sessions to be held in 2 locations in Dearborn County. Leaders in business education, faith, government, and the media who can have a major influence in the area will be invited.
So this is a continuation of what they already did for the city?
I guess. I don't know. But we've got that one. Do you want to vote on these one at a time, folks?
I got a question on this one. Where are these going to be held at, the 2 half-day sessions?
Don't know. Doesn't say.
Anybody from the foundation in the audience?
No.
I don't see Jenny here.
They threw it all to me.
It is in Dearborn County. Don't say where.
So we can get a hold of Denise. Ask her.
Vote on the regular. Just do the whole line.
You can vote on them however you want to.
But Jane, I have nothing that says where they're going to be held.
That's okay. I'm in agreement with it. I'd just like to know where it's going to be held.
It will be held in Dearborn County.
Yeah, it's going to be held here somewhere.
We're
going to do them one or
just do them individual. Okay. Entertain a motion.
So moved.
Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
There needs signs. She'll get with you later.
Yeah.
I'll sign them.
Or you sign them, whatever.
I sign them.
Okay.
The next one is Carnegie Historic Landmarks Preservation Society. The project is the restoration refurbishment of second floor of Carnegie Hall Museum. They're asking for $95,601. The recommendation from the foundation is $95,601. For the restoration refurbishment, which is plaster, paint, and electrical work, for Carnegie Hall Museum, which is on the National Register of Historic Places.
Anything on the board? Stand a motion.
So moved.
Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it.
Okay. Okay, the next one is the City of Aurora. The project is the redevelopment of Aurora Recreation Community Center. The Recreation Community Center, Senior Center, and Parks of Aurora, which include signage, lighting, flooring, chairs, banners, and bleachers. They're asking for $60,900 $1,847. And the foundation recommends $44,400 for the replacement flooring of the first and second floor entry hallway of the ARCC building, floor and chair replacement for the senior center, and 12 sets of bleachers with concrete and supplies for pads for the baseball and football fields.
Any discussion? Entertain a motion?
Motion to approve.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it.
Okay. Dillsborough Volunteer Fire Department. The project is command vehicle replacement, including all equipment, lights, sirens, installation, and radios. They're asking for $71,011. The foundation recommends $49,000 for the replacement command vehicle to include the installation of equipment and lights and sirens only. This vehicle will replace a 1999 Dodge Durango. The existing radios from the old truck can be used and still have a 3 to 4 useful life remaining.
Any discussion? Entertain a motion?
Motion to approve.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
Okay, the next one is Paws of Dearborn County. The project is a replacement vehicle for their animal transport to include custom animal transport conversion and graphic van wrap. They're asking for $56,576. The foundation recommends $52,880 for the replacement vehicle and custom animal transport conversion. This vehicle replaces a 2003 Dodge van that is severely rusted and has numerous maintenance issues. This vehicle is used weekly for vet runs and monthly adoption events. The graphic van wrap was not recommended.
Any discussion? Entertain a motion?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Okay. Aurora Lions Club. Their project is fair management items for the annual farmers fair. They're asking for $45,450. The foundation recommends $30,000 towards fair management items of the annual farmers fair, which includes stage, sound, and lighting, street crafters, rental equipment, sanitation, security, etc.
Any discussion? Entertain a motion?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it.
Okay. Lawrenceburg High School / LCSC. The project is equipment for a new weight room. They were asking for $45,000. The foundation recommends $0 based on information in the grant application. It appears there is adequate equipment to serve the needs of the students, and there would be limited community use of the weight room.
Any discussion? Entertain a motion?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Okay, let's see. We're still going. Hamline Chapel, United Methodist Church. Their project is restoration of the historic pipe organ. Requested amount $22,100. The foundation recommends $22,100 for the restoration of the historic pipe organ located inside Hamline Chapel, United Methodist Church. The pipe organ has provided almost 78 years of service and is in need of restoration. It is tuned and serviced biannually, and the last time major work was done to the organ was back in 1989.
The only thing I would tell you on this one, there was already a claim filed by the church because they said the construction of the event center did damage to the organ. Our insurance company did deny the claim, didn't find that it was caused by us. I don't know if this is just, you know, doing it on the back end, but that's the only thing I want to tell you guys.
Any discussion? Entertain a motion?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Dearborn County 4-H Clubs Association. The project is the Livestock Barn Fans Head Show Rails, Horse Arena Surface, Soil Groomer, Science Educational Presentations, and Ventilation of the Barn Cupolos. Their requested amount was $41,080. The foundation recommends $15,100 for Livestock Barn Fans Head Show Rails, Horse Arena Surface Groomer, and Science Educational Presentation. The ventilation barn cupolos would be improvements to property not owned by the Dearborn County 4-H. Per DCF policies, improvements to property not owned by the grant applicant are not allowed. So they want to allow 15-1 for everything but the
barn
ventilation of the barn cupolos.
Well, correct me if I'm wrong. When they came to show us those, I thought we were buying them anyway. Or did they say they were going to buy them?
I don't remember us buying them. I thought they said they were going to do improvements. We had to see the improvements or see the picture of them, if I remember right, before. I think they were supposed to get with you out.
It was the Parks Board. I remember it came in front of Parks. But I thought at that time they said that they would be, maybe this is how they were going to pay for it. I don't know. But they didn't approve those anyway, so.
Any discussion, board? Entertain a motion.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
Dearborn County Sheriff's Department. The project is 800 megahertz radio upgrade for the Reserve Deputy Program, which includes Hidden Valley POA. They were asking for $15,567. The foundation recommended the $15,567 for the purchase and installation of four 800 system radios, one for each of the three police cruisers used exclusively by the reserve deputies, and one to be used as a base station for Hidden Valley Lake Field Office. With the new radios, communications will be restored with increased response time and greater safety for the officers and the public.
Any discussion? Entertain a motion?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
Okay.
Mayor, I got a question on these grants.
Go ahead.
Mr. Landing, did you ever apply for the $100,000 grant for the software for the Lawrenceburg Police Department?
I went over and spoke with him, and he advised that he could not give me a grant to pay back money that was already acquired from a different account.
Well, do you remember me getting the message to you that we would withhold payment so it wouldn't be a reimbursement? That you could go ahead and apply to the grant? I talked to somebody in Jackie's office. I talked
to
Les.
I said relay it, yeah.
Talked to Suzanne. She relayed it to you.
Yeah, he still said that, it wouldn't be, it would be the same as if, because the money was already, from my understanding, coming out of 10 county grant, correct?
Only if you acquired the $100,000 grant.
And when I went and spoke with him about the $100,000 grant, again, he said that it's like if they went ahead and approved the money for to come out of the 10 county grant, then it's going to be like me giving you $100,000 to pay back to the 10 county grant. Is the way he presented it to me. Does that make sense?
Leslie, did we approve the full amount that night or minus the $100,000?
You approved the full, mm-hmm, with contingent upon him going and applying for the grant.
Right.
I believe that's how it was, wasn't it?
I think so.
Yeah.
And that's what the information he gave me.
The problem was, I think, was we had until whatever the date was to pay that money, and if we didn't, the contract prices would go
up.
I don't remember the date now.
April something.
Yeah,
it was March
something. We were on a deadline, and even if he did apply for the grant, the money wouldn't have came in time.
Right.
Right. And that was the other thing. He said that the phase two grants weren't, the deadline application for those wasn't until June, so we were way past the deadline for that. And he even said that too. He said, even if you were to apply for it, you know, our deadline for that is not until June for phase two grants. So he did say that too as well, because when I went in and talked to him, I asked him about a phase two grant.
Okay, in the near future, with any of our departments, if we know that we need equipment or anything, think to apply through the Dearborn Community Foundation before going into our reserves, which we don't have much reserves or much revenue anymore.
Jane, if I can make a comment, I went over and was trying to apply for a training seat for putting install car seats for taking around all these people, and I was told I was not allowed to apply because it's double dipping for the county grant. I'm not allowed to go for it. Raising money myself.
City of Lawrenceburg can't apply to their own foundation?
No. I don't know. I'd have to look at the parameters of the program. I haven't reviewed those in a long time, but it may have been that we put it in that way. But I can double check on it.
Okay. Well, thanks for trying.
Well, I mean, I just, you know, because it's kind of disheartening when you can't get stuff when your budget's kind of, you know, you're stretched.
Well, but we can change that.
Well, yeah. I mean, that's something we can definitely address
with them and say, hey, no, yes, we want part of this now.
That would be nice. I mean, I'm trying to deal with DCH and some of these other people, and, you know, raising some money to get this. It's not a whole lot of money. It's like $1,500, but it's something that can travel and go other places. But I just want to bring that to your attention.
Leslie, can you look into that to see if we can get that changed?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay.
And maybe next year, because we did already sign the agreement with them.
For this year.
Yeah.
All right, Leslie Votaw, Zoning Amendment Section 154-40, signs.
Mike and I talked about this, and actually this was prepared by my office by Mr. Johns. This is something he had already presented to the Plan Commission, and they had approved it and passed it on to you all. However, when reviewing this today, I realized that the changes were not marked in the attachment. Therefore, I would have to read the whole ordinance. I would ask that, I don't think we're in a huge rush to pass it. We could address it at the next meeting. I would ask that you table this, and I can we can bring back the notated changes to you all so you can compare them.
Entertain a motion?
Yeah, I had one question.
Well,
I didn't know what was new, what was old, because I don't have my book with me tonight, but it says in one area here to for the political signs that it must have a minimum of 6 inches of clear space all around the sides of a said sign.
Okay, you're talking about under H?
On the last page.
Yeah, on the last page.
Mm-hmm. Number 5 on the very last page. But if you're going to hang a banner, that's not going to, whatever you're going to hang it to is not going to have 6 inches around it. If you're going to put a sign in a window, it's not going to have 6 inches around it.
Aaron, the intent of that was you're allowed 16 square feet.
Mm-hmm.
So one sign is 16 square feet. You can't have two of them with a quarter inch separation to make it appear to be a larger sign. So you don't have, as long as you don't have another sign closer than 6 inches to it, you're fine.
Yeah,
you don't have to have.
Yeah, because it doesn't say within another sign. It just says each sign erected or placed shall have a minimum of 6 inches of clear space all around the said signs of.
Yeah, so as long as you don't have anything encroaching within that 6 inches, you're fine.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You will if you're putting a sign up in a window. The window's within 6 inches. If you're putting a banner to a porch, that's not 6 inches. That's 0 inches. It won't work for some instances like that. It doesn't say within another sign. It just says within anything.
That's what the intent was. What I can do is get with Mr. Johns to get a clarification on that. If that suits you, and we'll have that for the next meeting.
Is this a new provision?
Yes.
Okay. Like I said, I just thought, I mean, you could go through and look at the ordinance and compare it, but it's quite lengthy, and I didn't think you guys wanted to see through me reading the whole ordinance tonight.
Yeah, I was wondering what the changes were as well.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'll make a motion to table.
Thank you.
Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All in opposed.
Mike, you don't happen to have a copy of it, do you?
I, not with me. I attached the amended version.
It's in your planning commission packet.
Yeah, I did not.
Meeting.
Yeah.
I didn't attach what we had at the public hearing at the planning commission, so that same copy that was in your planning commission minutes will be attached at the next meeting.
Yeah, we'll make sure it's in there. Okay. Thank you.
Bob Ogle, bike event modifications.
Bob Ogles, well, they tabled the motion last time. There were some concerns. I'd like to apologize, first of all, for the ones of you who got packets. Up until late Friday afternoon, I thought the utility director's name was Kantz. I didn't realize it was Clausen. It was an awesome mistake. But anyway, on his concerns of the electric bill and that Bobo's and the levee breaker were the same thing, they're not. The BC 100 through the state of Indiana has been filed. McGraw-Timmons accounting firm has done the IRS work. And actually, I just help my wife out. I'm an advisor. I'm in there a lot. But actually, my concerns very soon will be moving to the American State Bank building. Anyway, on Mr. Clausen's concerns. Finance System Incorporated is the collection company that the city of Lawrenceburg uses. There was a payment made Friday of $218.42. There'll be five more payments on the 15th of each month. The city council or anybody, I guess, with the utility company can verify this with Christina at the number of this finance systems company.
Thank you. We'll make sure this gets to Mr. Clausen.
Okay. As far as your concerns, mm-hmm. There's a certificate of insurance. Sites Insurance has my verbal permission to give you anything else that you may possibly need.
No,
okay.
This is fine.
Chief Tremaine and Assistant Chief Lanning last week, they wanted me to revise the street plan. I did what you wanted.
Good with.
Okay. And Mr. Fryman, he had mentioned assembly in A&E. Anyway, it was mailed today. So it's on its way to Indianapolis or wherever. I guess I'll kind of re-present what I did since Mr. Cook, Mr. Bruno weren't here last week. On the 26th, they're doing the Queen City Wheels bike race down here. I would say with music on the river and this bike race, if the weather is good, I would say there'll be 1,500 to 2,000 people down here. The levee breaker will set up a food and soft drink stand at each location, music on the river, and in front of my wife's restaurant. The levee breaker wants to expand the Vine Street seating, which we've covered there with Assistant Chief Lanning. The levee breaker will supply the fencing, the tents, the draft beer trailer, security, and the necessary permits from excise. The only two businesses that would be affected or could be affected would be the event center and Cyclops Bikes. Mr. Keller and Greg Tufts from the casino, I have your blessings. I'm not asking for any cash assistance or anything else. I just want the opportunity to do it, make this a good event. If we pull it off, it's something that may come back to Lawrenceburg.
Anything aboard? Go ahead, Carl.
I would suggest that would be upon approval of the A&E permit, because everything he's saying, the fire department and the police department for the evacuation and the seating and all, has to be presented on the A&E anyway, and then the fire department actually signs off on it at that point.
So it would be, if they made the motion tonight, they could do it contingent upon the A&E being approved? Okay.
Okay. Any discussion? Entertain a motion.
I make a motion to allow the levee breaker to expand Vine Street seating to the beer garden area with the stipulation that it be approved by...
The state of Indiana.
By the state of Indiana.
Actually, I believe it's connected somehow with Homeland Security now. The A&E is...
Application's already in the mail.
Yeah, I mailed it today.
That's pertaining to with the police department.
Contingent upon the A&E permit.
Yeah.
You have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have.
Thank you.
Thank you. Lastly, second reading, second, third reading of ordinance 3, 2015.
This will be ordinance 3, 2015, which is the ordinance establishing operating fee from Riverboat Fund. Just to give the two members that weren't here last time, Mr. Hedden was here to explain this. In order to keep us below our maximum levy, how we adopted our budget, this fee would basically even it out. The operating fee would subsidize the levy, is how I understand it. Is that how you understand it, Suzanne? And, yeah.
I understand that the operating fee will subsidize the levy, which will keep the property taxes at the same. Mm-hmm. But I was not aware of that was not already built into the budget, and then we're going to have to appropriate more money to take care of the subsidy.
We didn't know till after budgets were approved, Jane, that there was going to be a problem, that we were going to have to do this. That's why it wasn't built into the budget.
I think from now on, obviously.
It will be this, yeah, for the 2016 and on, it will be put into the budget. But it's at the time you all did budgets that we didn't know this was going to be the case.
So that puts our budget up another, what was the amount?
$818,594. But it basically is just evening it out. It's so we're not...
Well, I was under the understanding when the budget went through that everything was put in the budget that would be needed to get us through the year.
They didn't know this, Jane.
Well, we knew. We've done it for the past two or three years. We haven't raised the tax levy on the taxpayers.
I guess, from my understanding, when I was contacted about this, which was probably back in April and March, I had those same questions. I didn't understand it. But, I mean, this is what we pay Unball for to do, and they're saying this is what is needed. So
this is just a way to take money from Riverboat to put in the general, where it should have been originally budgeted.
In the general,
to cover what was needed to begin with.
Correct. That's how I understand it.
And from here on out, it will automatically be taken for Riverboat.
Right, as part of the budget process. There will be a line item that says operating fee, Riverboat operating fee.
That's what it'll fall under?
Mm-hmm.
And that will only be used when and if necessary?
Yeah. According to what your mm-hmm. what your yeah. proposed
what Dan the said, yeah. budget. We'll yeah. only do it when we have to do it. Yes.
And you'll let us know when you use that, and well, you will on our reports.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Go ahead.
So I read ordinance 3, 2015 by title only. Ordinance establishing operating fee from Riverboat Fund.
Motion to suspend the rules. Read ordinance
3.
3, 2015 by title only. Second time.
So moved.
Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Ordinance establishing operating fee from Riverboat Fund, ordinance 3, 2015.
Motion to approve ordinance number 3, 2015, second reading by title only.
I'll move.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Motion to suspend the rules, read ordinance number 3, 2015 by title only for third and final reading.
I'll move.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Ordinance 3, 2015, ordinance establishing operating fee from Riverboat Fund.
Motion to approve ordinance number 3, 2015, third and final reading.
So moved.
Second?
Third.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Okay. Ordinance 5, 2015.
You want to do these later or this last time we're in there? And by signing this, you're approving this?
Yes.
Do you need another copy?
Where's mine?
Do you need another copy of three?
That's the original. There you go.
Okay, thank you.
Just to, again, give Mr. Cook and Mr. Bruner a rundown of this ordinance. This has to do with river, well, it pertains to Riverwatch, but it will also be for any other permanently moored vessel. If you remember, we were ready to go ahead and enforce our civil codes on that boat in particular. And then we were told by, I think when you talked to, who did you talk to at the state, someone at the state, that we had to actually enact an ordinance. Is that correct? So we have taken the language from the Army Corps of Engineers and the United States Coast Guard standards, which are their definitions of a permanently moored vessel. And so we added the definition of permanently moored vessel according to those manuals. And then also we basically just made Chapter 150, which is all the unsafe building, all the building commissioner's code, applicable to these permanently moored vessels.
That's the Corps of Engineers definition right there at the bottom.
Actually, it is. This is the we had a decision that we got from the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, and they referenced the Coast Guard.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. So yeah, but that's. So I guess we need a motion.
To motion to suspend the rules. Orders number 5, 2015, by title only, second time.
So moved.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Ordinance number 5, 2015, ordinance amending section 15001 and to add section 150.07 to title, that would be title 15.
Most approved ordinance number 5, second reading by title only.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Most suspended rules, ordinance number 5, 2015, by title only, third and final reading.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Ordinance number 5, 2015, ordinance amending section 150.01 and to add section 150.07 to title 15.
Post approved ordinance number 5, 2015, third and final reading.
I move.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Same thing, it's just on the same page there. I didn't plan. And you're approving these by signing these?
Yes.
Thank you. I'll ask any other time now.
Any comments for the audience? The one wants to talk? Come on, we want somebody to talk.
You want somebody to talk.
Okay. Review and discuss claims for board approval.
Your Honor, I got one question. On accounts payable register, the money going to the LCD, is it going to the LCDs or is it still going in escrow?
It's going to escrow.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. I have one question.
Go ahead.
The $2 million is in there about Ivy Tech, and then I read where they got projects on hold.
What do you want to discuss that?
All those approvals were done last year. So the article that mentioned the fiscal year starting this July 1st has no bearing on those previous approved dollars. I've got a statement I can read there and give you a copy of the email I received from Ivy Tech confirming that today.
So you inquired with them about it? You inquired once you saw?
Yeah, because when I heard it, as you know, and if I went back through and looked at the file, we already had Senator Luke Kennelly had signed off, the state board of accounts had signed off on it. Everybody had signed off, and that was based on 14's budget.
I just want to ask.
That project will move forward.
Yes, it's stated here that the bid documents will be available first week of June. So it should start construction by October.
Okay. Entertain a motion.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion adjourned?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
That was a good one. That was pretty good. I know.
Yeah, I just seen that. Kind of surprised.